Hello and welcome. You're watching the News Unlocked, the show that takes you behind the headlines to the stories that matter. This on a day when an all-out political war has erupted in Maharashtra over whether religious places should be opened or not. The opposition wants them open. The chief minister appears reluctant. We're not going to get into the politics that we've already discussed earlier. We're going to look at the specific need, if there is any at this moment, to open up places of worship in this festive season during COVID times. Because remember, while the overall numbers across India show a sign of easing, is that reason enough to open up places of worship across the country? Or can they be opened with standard operating protocols? The dilemma, in a sense, is one of what do you put first, health or faith? First up, let's start this special from Maharashtra, the state where the governor and the chief minister have been engaged in a war of words over the reopening of temples. Take a look.
The BJP launched protests across Maharashtra for the opening of temples, as the state government remained adamant on keeping them closed because of the pandemic. From Siddhivinayak Temple to Shirdi Sai Temple, protesters raised slogans against the Uddhav government. And even as the protests took place, Governor Bhagat Singh Koshyari opened another front against Uddhav Thackeray. In a letter, he said, if bars could open, so must the temples. It led to a fierce face-off between Raj Bhavan and Sachivalay, the centre-appointed governor versus the Aghadi coalition's Shiv Sena chief minister.
Uddhav Thackeray ji, aapko hindutva ka praman patra aur paath rajyapal mahoday se lene ka samay aa chuka hai.
Uddhav, in a biting response to the governor, said he didn't need a hindutva certificate from Koshyari.
Dekhiye, mandir aur bar ki aap jo tulna kar rahe ho galat hai. रेस्टोरेंट्स खोल रहे हैं राज्य में जनता के हित में क्या निर्णय लेना है क्या नहीं लेना है उसका पूरा अधिकार राज्य के मुख्यमंत्री को है.
The conflict on opening temples comes at a time when the center has been stressing that large gatherings must be avoided at all costs to keep COVID infections at bay.
जब त्योहार आते हैं हम इकट्ठे होते हैं हम एक दूसरे से मिलते हैं और ये बातें जो हम करते हैं ये वायरस को भी अच्छी लगती हैं उसका फायदा वायरस उठा के एक सिचुएशन पैदा ऐसी कर सकते हैं कि जिसमें कि इकट्ठ होने वाले जो इवेंट हैं हमारे वो सुपर स्प्रेडर इवेंट्स बन सकते हैं.
एट अ टाइम व्हेन बिग रिलीजियस फेस्टिवल्स आर जस्ट अराउंड द कॉर्नर देयर इज अ रिस्क ऑफ द केस लोड इंक्रीजिंग लाइक इट हैपेंड इन केरला. According to studies, 65% of Kerala's total cases were recorded after Onam festivities. Three other Indian states saw a spike in COVID cases after festivals in August. Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Maharashtra celebrated Ganesh Chaturthi on 22nd of August. Andhra registered 68% of the total cases reported by the state. Maharashtra recorded 47% of all cases in the state. And nearly 50% of Telangana's total cases were recorded after the festival.
While debate of opening religious places rages, it's quite clear Maharashtra's COVID worries are far from over. It has highest number of COVID cases with load of over 1.5 million cases. With Sahil, Vidya and Kamlesh, this is Saurabh Vakhtania in Mumbai for India Today.
Is this the right time to open up places of worship? Dr. Shashank Joshi is member of the COVID task force in Maharashtra. I'm also joined by Mahesh Jadhav. He's trustee at the Mahalakshmi Devasthan in Kolhapur and chairman Paschim Maharashtra Devasthan Committee. And I'm also joined by Rahul Ishwar, who's been an activist and been associated in the past with the Sabarimalai temple. Thank you all very much for joining me. I want to come to the doctor first because, Dr. Joshi, the charge being made at the moment, particularly against the Maharashtra government, is that, look, if you can open Vaishno Devi, if you can open Tirupati, if you can open temples in Delhi, Akshardham has opened today, why can you not open up temples in Maharashtra? There is a standard protocol that the center has put in place, why not open temples? What's the hesitation?
So, Rajdeep, we need to go by data and science. And the data of Ganesh Chaturthi and the spike is extremely well documented and is in place. I am not saying that we do not need to unlock. We need to unlock sensibly, mindfully, and very gradually and slowly. So as far as places of worship are concerned, we need to do a risk assessment. We need to ensure that the crowd control measures are in place. We need to have a standard operating protocol in place. And we have to see the timing at which, if a potential worship place is opened up, would it land up with a spike or a increase in the pandemic?
Sir, right, the center is saying, the center is saying there's already a protocol in place. You can control the crowds. You don't accept that?
No, I think it is the local administration and the local numbers which need to decide on that. If you see, Mumbai numbers have spiked up. We were having, before Ganesh Chaturthi, numbers between 700 to 1,200. Now we are every day having numbers of 2,500 and they just don't seem to be coming down. So we need to look at data and science. We can't just do this arbitrarily. The administration needs to be ready and prepared to handle this with the help of the places of worship. If they have sufficient security, sufficient stringent... See, most important thing, Rajdeep, is COVID-appropriate behavior, COVID-appropriate responsibility, and COVID-appropriate habits. Are we really seeing that being adhered to in Mumbai or Maharashtra? No. If you go on the streets of Mumbai, people are simply not masking. Till that is not in order and till we don't have responsible citizen behavior demonstrated over a sustained period of time, which translates into the numbers of COVID, I do not think we should be acting irresponsibly. I am not saying that economy doesn't need to unlock. Economy needs to unlock. Independent of faith, we need to look at data and science, and we cannot afford to have a spike which will again completely break the back of the healthcare infrastructure and system, and we cannot afford to lose lives, because as we approach winter, we know that there is a likelihood of a second peak, pollution will go up, there will be likelihood of a crowded cluster, festive season is coming up, and people are simply not being responsible.
Dr. Joshi, I think you put it in some context. You're saying, go by data, go by science. Post Ganesh Chaturthi in Maharashtra, post Onam in Kerala, there has been a spike in cases, which is why you need to be cautious. I'll just come back to you because Mahesh Jadhav, you are trustee at the Mahalakshmi Devasthan. Aap mujhe bataiye, kya aapko lagta hai ki ye sahi samay hai ki mandiron ko kholna chahiye, Diwali aa rahi hai, festival season aa raha hai, kya aapko lagta hai ki kahin na kahin is baar swasth aur जिस तरह से कोविड फैल रहा है उस पर ज्यादा ध्यान होना चाहिए? भक्ति आप घर में भी कर सकते हैं।
नमस्कार राजदीप जी, अभी तो ये समय ऐसा है कि अभी अभी कोरोना का प्रादुर्भाव कम हो रहा है, और ऐसे में महाराष्ट्र में लगातार नवरात्र का उत्सव अभी नजदीक आ रहा है, तो नवरात्र के उत्सव में बड़ी तादाद से भक्त लोग मंदिर में आते हैं। अभी महालक्ष्मी टेम्पल में लगभग नवरात्र के नौ दिन में कम से कम 15 से 20 लाख लोग आते हैं, तो ऐसे में मंदिर खोलेंगे तो प्रादुर्भाव संसर्ग बढ़ सकता है। इसके वास्ते मुझे तो ऐसा लगता है कि महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट ने ये नवरात्र उत्सव में जानबूझकर ये अभी मंदिर न खोलने की जो योजना बनाई है, उसका जो निर्णय लिया है, ये नवरात्र के बाद मंदिर खोलेंगे। अभी तो ये कोल्हापुर में जो जगतचंडी महालक्ष्मी अंबाबाई का जो स्थान है, अभी कोल्हापुर में बहुत बड़ा कोरोना का महासंकट चल रहा था, अभी पिछले 15 दिन से ये कम हो रहा है। तो बाकी
तो क्या आप समझते हैं, जो मैं आपसे पूछ रहा हूँ, जो सरकार ने किया है वो सही है कि नहीं, कि नवरात्र के समय जब आप कह रहे 15 लाख लोग आते हैं उन 9 दिनों में आपके मंदिर में, इस समय मंदिर का खोलना गलत है या सही है?
अभी इस समय मंदिर खोलना वैसे थोड़े धोखे की घंटा हो सकती है, उसकी संसर्ग बढ़ सकता है, तो नवरात्र के नजदीक ये मंदिर, इस कोल्हापुर का मंदिर खोलेंगे तो बड़ी मुश्किल आ सकती है, ऐसा मुझे लगता है।
चलो, दैट्स अ गुड ग्राउंड, यू नो, व्हाइल पॉलिटिशियंस टेल यू टेक दिस पोजीशन, हियर इज समवन हु हैंडल्स वन ऑफ द मंदिर्स वार्निंग that in Kolhapur, for example, or even in Mumbai, numbers could rise, there could be a spike. Rahul Ishwar, let me take that there for you. It's, you know, all of us would like everything to open up. you know, we want things to open up, but there has to be some caution. Do you believe the time has come for those who are devotees? Maybe 2020, you observe the rituals that you believe in at home. Why do I need to go to the Mahalakshmi Mandir? Why do I need to go to Siddhi Vinayak? Maybe for once, we need to observe some restraint. I'm not getting your audio, Rahul.
Sorry. These are the first two demands. Let us close down the temples.
Rahul, you need to unmute yourself.
Yeah. We were the first to demand. We were the first to demand. Let us close the temples. The temples, churches and mosques, they had a huge meeting and then demanded let us close it down and let us not open it. But having said that, we are living in a new normal. See, temples, churches or mosques or all places of worship are also spiritual and cultural places. People do have spiritual and cultural needs. That's the reason why this congregation happens. That's the reason why this coming together happens. And especially regarding the Hindu temples, one more aspect is there. There is a concept of Chaitanya for the deity. So the regular pujas or the Nitya pujas should definitely be there. And that cannot be violated. So we are living in a new normal. We are, you know, India as a civilization.
Rahul, what comes first? Health or your or belief and faith? What comes first?
There is no doubt that, you know, our own health, and we believe that our body is temple. You know, according to our Hindu philosophy, we believe that the body is temple. At the same point of time, a real temple where the deity is there and where the worshipping is there, every, you know, as a devotee, I would like to go. But please remember, Shabarimala takes around 5 lakh people per day. This year, we have reduced it to 5,000. So we are not blindly superstitious people who are unwilling to engage with the scientific community. Just the opposite, we are willing to take all the necessary precautions from the government, doctors and scientists. But we are only requesting that all the other things are being opened up. Why single out religious places? Why single out places
because of the sheer worship? Numbers. Rahul Ishwar, after Onam in Kerala, after Ganesh Chaturthi in Maharashtra, and we've seen it even with festivals in Andhra Pradesh, numbers have spiked up. Why should any government take that chance?
No, government should definitely implement strict COVID protocols and a new normal awareness in all the believers like us. And trust me, not even a believer will have a murmur in following this, because we know they are doing it for our own good. That's the reason why I pointed out an example in Kerala, where the Kerala government was ready to open up, but the temples, churches and mosques said, let us not open it right now. So we are a very understanding group of people. At the same point of time, we also have the spiritual and cultural needs which needs to be fulfilled and satisfied. And don't single out these religious institutions, because every other thing is opening up. Don't treat it as a second category stuff or, you know, secondary stuff. When the other things can open, let us also have the responsibility to go to a new normal and behave responsibly.
Let me give a sense of what's happening across the country, because remember, this is not just happening in Maharashtra. What's happened? What has been the example with the Siddhi Vinayak, with Tirupati? Because as India's festival season approaches, there will be pressure to open up popular religious spots. Public health experts, of course, are warning governments to exercise caution. What's the reality, though, on the ground? Take a look.
किसी भी धर्म में कोई भी धर्माचार्य यह नहीं कहते कि लोगों के प्राणों को खतरे में डालकर त्यौहार मनाया जाना चाहिए। कभी कोई भी भगवान यह नहीं कहते कि उनकी पूजा के लिए आपको बड़े बड़े पूजा पंडालों में जाने की जरूरत है।
Religious places in India outside containment zones had been allowed to open in June. However, there were advisories which said that persons above 65 years of age, those with comorbidities, pregnant women and children below the age of 10 years should stay at home. While the central government relaxed rules, many state governments and even individual temples had chosen to stay shut as COVID-19 caseload increased across India. Finally, one of the biggest temples in the capital, the Akshardham temple, reopened today after a gap of more than 6.5 months.
It's a very big area, so we don't have any particular number. Even 5,000 comes, we have that, space. They can keep the social distance and go.
There are other popular religious spots that too have reopened to devotees. Vaishno Devi in Jammu and Kashmir resumed pilgrimages in mid-August. And devotees claim they are not afraid to venture out.
So तो मूव ऑन तो करना ही पड़ेगा, फिर कोरोना के चक्कर में सारे काम हो रहे हैं तो माता के दर्शन भी होंगे।
जितने लोग हम यहाँ आए हैं सबने कोविड टेस्ट कराया, कोविड टेस्ट करा के हम हमारी यहाँ एंट्री हुई है, तो इसलिए हमें किसी चीज़ का डर नहीं, क्योंकि अपनी सब कुछ हम साथ लेके अपने सैनिटाइजर के साथ लेके आए हैं, मास्क लगा के आए हैं और मास्क लगा के हमने यात्रा करी है।
ऊपर भी बहुत फैसिलिटीज़ हैं, सैनिटाइजर्स एवरीथिंग इज़ देयर, बट जब भी कुछ अगर ऐसा हो जाएगा तो मैं अपने आप को जिम्मेदार मानूंगा।
Devotees thronging the southern shrine of Tirupati claim to believe the same. Many of the devout thronging the temples hope to be cautious but insist that a temple visit will cheer them up.
Temple gives us a sense of sanctity. So though it has been opened, it is upon us to, you know, practice caution in, you know, visiting places.
Practicing coming to temple from our childhood, okay, we can't change this suddenly, immediately. We can't change this type of activity. Pandemic still there, but we have to follow some rules and regulations as per the government rule. So we are following same regulations.
All the religious places which have reopened, medical experts and governments continue to warn the public against visiting crowded spaces, including large religious gatherings. Some experts warn. One must not forget that internationally, religious places and gatherings in the past have been super spreaders of COVID-19 infections. So one must think hard before making same mistakes all over again.
So there you have it, Dr. Shashank Joshi. There are rules that are being followed about number of devotees, for example, that you can have in a temple, in Akshardham, Vaishno Devi. Do you believe, therefore, with rules, even Siddhi Vinayak in Mumbai or any temple in the country or a place of worship, a mosque or church could open?
So, Rajdeep, we need to do a risk assessment. Let me honestly confess, at a personal level, I am a devotee myself and I would like to go and do darshan of Siddhi Vinayak. But that doesn't mean that we need to see three things. Number one is, what is the risk assessment of Siddhi Vinayak? Do they have the SOP which has been recommended by government to be put in place? Would they be able to do a crowd control measure? Would there be no pandemonium there? Would it be a law and order situation? Is the administration and the temple authorities able and capable of handling that? Mm-hmm. So we need to ensure that if there is a COVID appropriate protocol put in place with a very limited number, maybe 10 or 15% of the anticipated crowd. Remember, in temples, the devotees on a particular day mm-hmm. go in lakhs. And then the crowd clustering is very high.
No, but so can't you say that you will only have 5,000 devotees? That is the responsibility of the temple trust. Can the government not leave it to the temple trust to work it out?
I feel across the world, including South Korean churches, to United Kingdom, to United States, all the spreader events have been possible because they left it to the places of worship, and the data has not supported that science. If there is a reasonable undertaking given by a place of worship and the governmental administration is able to handle it, that is great. But are we basically following a simple thing like masking in Mumbai city? When we are not able to do that, I don't know how we are able to make that correlate. So I think it is important that responsible behavior and a risk assessment mm-hmm. with the administration, the local administration has to be ready for it, with the temple authorities. And in a very limited way, for 10 to 20%, mm-hmm. possibly there is a likelihood that if it is a complete crowd control measure, complete decontamination protocol in place, mm-hmm. there is likelihood that it is not impossible. And other communities, we respect every community, but I think it is not possible. Do you think Mahalakshmi Temple in Navratri mm-hmm. can do crowd control and can do law and order situation?
Let me ask that to Mahesh Jadhav. Mahesh Jadhav, Dr. Joshi keh rahe hai, kya Mahalakshmi Temple Navratra ke time pe crowd control kar payegi? जो 15 लाख लोगों की बात करते हैं, आप कह सकते हैं किसी श्रद्धालु से कि आप आज मत आइए, आज ज्यादा लोग होंगे, क्या आप क्राउड कंट्रोल कर पाएंगे?
वैसे तो हम भक्त लोगों को ऐसा कह नहीं सकते, क्योंकि ये भीड़ बहुत ज्यादा होगी और नवरात्रि के दरमियान मैंने बोला है 15-20 लाख लोग आते हैं, हर रोज 2 लाख लोग आते हैं, तो उसमें कुछ लोगों को छोड़ना और कुछ लोगों को नहीं छोड़ना, ऐसा भेदभाव हम नहीं कर सकते। ये भीड़ कंट्रोल नवरात्रि के उत्सव में ये करना वैसे बड़े मुश्किल का काम है, लेकिन देवस्थान समिति ने वैसी तैयारी बराबर की है, जो आने वाले हैं सभी 4 दरवाजे मंदिर को चार दरवाजे से एक दरवाजे से लोगों को छोड़ेंगे भक्तों को
सर, उसमें सैनिटेशन होना पड़ेगा, लेकिन सैनिटेशन होना पड़ेगा, मास्क
सैनिटेशन वो सब वैसी तैयारी हमने की है, सैनिटाइजर होगा, उसका थर्मल टेस्टिंग होगा, उसका ऑक्सीमीटर ले लेंगे और सभी लोगों को मास्क लगाना जरूर पड़ेगा, उसका सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का 3 फीट का अंतर हम रखेंगे, ये सब तैयारी की है। लेकिन अभी अभी 8-6 दिन रह गए हैं, उसमें 17 अक्टूबर को ये घटस्थापना नवरात्र शुरू होने वाली है, तो इसमें लगभग वक्त बहुत कम है और उसमें मंदिर के दरवाजे महाराष्ट्र की गवर्नमेंट खोलेंगे और उसकी आदेश निकालेंगे मंदिर खोलने का, ऐसा मुझे नहीं लगता है।
तो ये यही सवाल
आदेश आएगा गवर्नमेंट का,
राहुल ईश्वर,
मंदिर का वो व्यवस्थापन जरूर हैंडल कर सकते हैं,
आपकी बात मुझे
है, लेकिन करना पड़े तो कर सकेंगे,
करना पड़े तो कर सकेंगे। क्विक फाइनल वर्ड फ्रॉम यू राहुल ईश्वर, इजंट इट बेटर टू बी सेफ देन सॉरी? व्हाट इज रॉन्ग इफ फॉर वन ईयर वी हैव 2020 इज अ ईयर लाइक नो अदर, नवरात्र में वेल हैव टू बी सेलिब्रेटेड डिफरेंटली, लेट्स एक्सेप्ट इट।
दैट्स इट सर, आई होप यू विल रिमेंबर दीस आर वेरी स्ट्रगलिंग टाइम्स एंड ट्रबलिंग टाइम्स, पीपल अदरवाइज आर ऑल्सो वेरी स्ट्रेस्ड, so naturally temple is a place where they get some kind of a consolation. I totally agree with Shashank sir's point. So he is an eminent person, so do handhold us, upgrade us, update us to the modern scenario. That's what we can do, right? We are ordinary believers who doesn't have in-depth understanding of science, so please do update and upgrade us, and all the temples have necessary funds to upgrade and update them, even all the COVID protocols. So please help us in, you know, getting to that level rather than stopping us, because these are troubling times where the believers want some kind of a solace. That's the reason why all the temples, churches and mosques become all the more important, because there are a lot of challenges, jobs are going, there is insecurity. We want some kind of a solace, you know, we can
I appreciate your need for solace, I appreciate your faith, your sense of belief, but at the end of the day, the sense one gets in 2020, you simply have to work towards a new normal. And if that means perhaps worshipping at home, then so be it. Either way, I think it's for the local administrations to take these tough decisions based, as Dr. Joshi said, on data and science above all else. This is a moment where science must score over faith. Thanks for joining us. That's it on The Divine Dilemma. You're watching The News Unlocked. The news without the noise, it's possible. Bye for now.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.